Hello friends, in this video we are discussing about types of stone machinery. Let us start about stone machinery. Stone machinery is one of the type of machineries which is divided into two types. First is rebel machinery and ashlar machinery. In the rebel machinery, again it is divided into three types: coarse rubble, lean coarse rubble and random rubble machinery. Whereas the ashlar machinery is divided into ashlar fine machinery, ashlar chamfered machinery and ashlar facing. Now let us start and discuss about one by one in detail. Talking about the stone machinery, the construction of stones bonded together with a mortar is termed as stone machinery, where the stones are available in a abundance in nature on cutting and dressing to the proper shape. So as we can see, the traditional built wall decomposition, wall crumbling, and the solution is through stones. Generally what happened in traditional way, we use this type of machinery which will be deteriorated as the time goes because of crumbling or because of delamination, and this can be solved by using through stones at a regular interval. As you can see, this will give the stability to your structures. Talking about the rubble machinery, first is uncoarse rubble machinery. This is the cheapest, roughest and poorest form of stone machinery. The stones used in this type of machinery vary much in their shape and size and are directly obtained from quarry. So these are, as the name indicates, these are uncoarse. That means these are not giving the proper shape or size. These are of varying size and shape and directly taken from the quarry. Uncoarse rubble machinery can be divided into two following parts. That is uncoarse random rubble, and second is uncoarse but squared rubble. The uncoarse rubble machinery, first is uncoarse random rubble machinery. So in this figure, as you can see, that is a random rubble machinery. The weak corners and edges are removed with machines, hammer. Generally bigger stones blocks are employed at quinces and jambs to increase the strength of machinery. So in a cross section, as you can see, this is the facing stones. Then we have some bond stones which are throughout the stones, as we discussed. Then we have small, that is cheap stones. Then hardening stones. So in such a way we are using random stones. That's what is known as uncoarse random rubble machinery. Let's talk about uncoarse square rubble. As you can see the difference between two figures, these are generally in proper manner. These are having the shape that are perfect, and as you can see the difference between both this figure and this figure, we have the shapes which are of irregular size, but over here, as you can see, we have some sharp edges. In this type, the stone blocks are made roughly square with hammer. Generally the facing stones are given hammer dress finish. Large stones are used as quinces. As far as possible, the use of chips in blading is avoided. So we are not using chips. So as you can see, this gives a better look. Then come regular course. Build to regular course. In this type of stone machinery, the uniform height stones are used in horizontal layers, not less than 13 cm in height. As you can see over here, we are using some stones having the same heights, uniform height, not less than 13 cm. Generally the stone beds are hammer or chisel to a depth of at least 10 cm from the face. From this face of wall, that is hammer or chisel up to 10 cm. The stones are arranged in such a manner so that the vertical joints of two consecutive courses do not coincide with each other. As you can see over here, alternate joints come above each other, but as you can see, there is no direct contact between the each layer. So in such a way, we have to provide it to avoid any cracking. Then come polygonal rubble machinery. In this type of machinery, the stones are roughly dressed to an irregular polygon shape. As you can see over here, we have used some which are having a irregular polygon shapes. The stones should be so arranged as to avoid long vertical joints. As you can see, there is no a straight long vertical joint, and to break joints as much as possible. Small stone chips should not be used to support the stones on the facing as shown in the figure. As you can see, we are using some polygon shaped stones and the vertical joints are avoided. Then flint rubble machinery. Flint rubble machinery, in this type, it is used in the areas where the flint is available in plenty. As you can see, this type of stones are known as flints. The flint stones varying in thickness from 8 to 15 cm and their length is from 15 cm to 30 cm are arranged in the facing in the form of coarse or uncoarse machinery as shown in the figure. As you can see over here, these are arranged in the length from 15 to 30 cm and their thickness is generally varying from 8 to 15 cm. They can be used as coarse or uncoarse. Then next comes is ashlar machinery. The ashlar machinery, the figure says, this type of machinery is generally give a very good bond, and these are ashlar rough machinery. As you can see, the surface of the stone is not given the proper finishing. These are the rough finish, whereas in this first figure, it is a ashlar fine finishing. As you can see, it is giving a very better look and a very good bond. These are some more example of ashlar machinery. As over here, we can see ashlar facing. So we are giving the facing wall with the uniform stones, which are giving a uniform facing. Over here, as you can see, we have used a ashlar chamfer. So these are chamfered properly by using chisels to give a decorative look over your brick or the stone wall. So these are some types of ashlar machinery generally used for artificial paper, and which will be give you very good bond and strength also. Then comes sills. As you can see, sills are generally nothing but the lower portion of your windows. So we required stone for the sealing purpose also. As over here, you can see sills are provided to give strength to your windows so that they can give some amount of loading also. And it is also available in different size and shapes, and we can use it below the windows. So in this video, we will discuss about types of stone machineries and their uses, and some figures are also shown which are useful in writing in exam. Thank you.